After generating code, we need to make sure that this code is correct. So just like we tested our components on the desktop, we need to make sure that also the source code behaves correctly. And for this reason, we can perform software in the loop, or also SIL. In particular, with SIL testing, we can reuse all the tests already created for our desktop, and we can even measure code coverage. So this is how it works. We have performed already some tests in modeling the loop, and we have collected results after running the component on those tests in Simulink. So we have generated code, and now we have obtained an object file. So this is exactly what we will use, and we will execute on our PC. And in particular, we can collect results, and we can compare the results of running the object code on our PC with the results obtained after running the tests on the desktop. And if they are equal, it means that the source code is correct. So we can use once again the Simulink test manager. So let me open a test that I have previously created. And here we can see that we have a MIL SIL test, and also we activate the coverage as we did previously with the desktop tests. So let me open the MIL SIL test case, and here we can see that we have a few equivalence tests. So with equivalence tests, essentially we compare the results of two different runs. In particular, the first run will be the one on our desktop in Simulink, and the second run will be exactly the same. But the only difference is that here we select software in the loop as simulation mode, which means that we don't run the Simulink model, but we run the object code. And same can be done also for processor in the loop. So we click on run, and we collect results for 11 different iterations for model in the loop and software in the loop. And here you can see that all the iterations have successfully passed. You can explore the results and you can make sure that they are exactly the same. You can see that the error is zero, so the source code behaves exactly as the desktop simulation. So if we go back to the results, we can also take a look at the coverage, just like we did for the desktop simulation. So you can click on the model here. You can have more details on the code coverage by clicking on the bottom left. And this little badge will show the report. And here you can have the details of the code coverage. After a static analysis of our code, we need to make sure that such code runs well also on our final target. And for this reason, we will perform processor in the loop, or PIL. And in particular, with processor in the loop, we can even measure the execution time on the final embedded microprocessor, which means how long it takes to run on the final hardware. And processor in the loop is essentially very similar to software in the loop. The only difference is that once we generate code, this will be cross-compiled. We obtain an object file that will run on the final execution target. So we can collect results, we can compare them to the desktop simulation, and if they're equal, it means that the object code runs well also on the final target. And in our case, we will use a board from BeagleBoard, and we will use a BeagleBone blackboard. Okay, so let me open a test harness. So here you can see a signal editor, and we need to make sure that we select the right board. So here I select BeagleBone Black, but that's the list of some of the hardware that we support directly. So you select the board of interest, and then here in the verification tab, you can enable the measured task execution time. So we go to the apps. And if we scroll down to code verification, validation, and test, we can select the SIL PIL manager. So the SIL PIL manager allows you to run model in the loop and software in the loop and processor in the loop simulations, and performs automatically back-to-back testing if you select automated verification. So the same could be done also from the test manager, as we saw before, but now we are running a single simulation, so it might be quicker to do it from here. And the SIL PIL manager automatically opens the simulation data inspector and shows you the results obtained after running the harness on desktop and after running the harness on the final target, that is the BeagleBone blackboard. And here you can see that all the signals are exactly the same, which means that the code running on the target behaves well. And now we can open a report. And in this report, we have information on the task execution time. That is, the time needed for the embedded target to run the code that we have automatically generated. And here you can see that we have 3,000 nanoseconds as task execution time, which is 3 microseconds. And also you can see in the simulation data inspector, the task execution time for each time instant.